curious, isn't it? Love can be a powerful weapon, it seems, even to those who are dead. Laura has spared him. Though she has the power to take his life, she has given it back, and all for love. Perhaps she remembers her true mother's arms around her, comforting her before she became this creature. Perhaps she remembers the feelings of love thought long lost to her heart all those years ago. A child's love is without bitterness or boundaries, a pure love. I wonder what will become of her, this lost soul, when we kill her present mother and send her to the pits of hell where she belongs.
Oh!
The vampire's mercy is playing on his thoughts. I see that clearly on his face. Perhaps Laura reminded him of poor Claudia. Seeing his beloved Marie again has brought it all back to him. Marie's love is all he has now, and the hope of holding her again, the only hope. He is close now, close to the bitch who commands these vampire vermin. Gabriel will make her pay for the injustices he has felt at her hands. She is powerful. She will try every trick in the book to tempt him to her cause. There is just the small matter of the Clockwork Tower to overcome first. Another mad invention of Frankenstein that I hope will only delay his sweet revenge. giant mechanisms and gears continue to turn, but Gabriel continues to foil them. He is now in the heart of evil. Darkness is all around, surrounding him from all sides. Here he will meet the brother of the one he destroyed in the village. His name is Olrox. The two brothers have been her greatest champions, yet I sense their reign of evil is ending here tonight. Olrox and his brother Brawner are traitors who took sides with the Queen when she became one of the Dark Lords. He has wreaked terror on the lands ever since. But now he will meet one who is greater, more powerful than he, one who will deliver a message without any mercy. Olrox, meet Gabriel Belmont and his vampire killer.
You shall not pass through here.
You shall not stand in my way.
The Dark Lady watches over. watches over us. Over you.
The blood of Olrox has opened the way to the Queen. She holds the next piece of the God Mask, which Gabriel must acquire if he is to be with his beloved again. She will try to seduce him, to glamour him, but he will see through her mask, I'm sure of it. He is so very strong now, and even she must fear her own death at his hands. I can smell her fear, her stench. Vampires can sense the living, but the dead she cannot. She knows Gabriel is here, yet she cannot sense death close at hand also. She knows what it is he wants. Poor, beautiful Carmilla, you will cry bloody tears before this night has ended.
I am told that you are looking for me, warrior. That you seek to obtain the power of my other half. You are brave and handsome. Would you not prefer to stay with me forever? I can show you many things, many pleasures.
Your empty promises mean nothing to me. You and your brothers have betrayed us all. You are the reason why the world is in darkness.
You are a fool, Gabriel. You think I don't know who you are? My sister, in her piety, wanted nothing but good for the world. But in her arrogance, she begat me and brought doom upon herself. Mankind is ruined. And you must choose sides, warrior.
I choose life, not death and decay as you have.
Death is merely a question of perspective. We are not so different, you and I. Your god cannot save you now. You will be one of us eventually. It is inevitable.
No. I will take the three powers and unite them.
You would kill those who founded your own holy order. You are even more cold-blooded than I. Who is the real monster here, Gabriel? You poor, deluded fool. You think you can bring someone back from the dead, don't you? Someone you love. You are betrayed. There is no resurrection. Only this living death you see before you. Join her then.
Blood.
pledge loyalty to you, and I may spare your life. Go, my children. Drink his blood. Do not resist. Become one with us. Lord. be free!
Oblivion. Sempiternum. Daemonis.
Soon, the destiny of every living being will be in the palm of your hand.
I now know that the founders of the Order created the Lords of Shadow. They are one and the same. They ascended into heaven as pure spirits, but left behind their dark sides. Why are we paying the price for their arrogance and stupidity? Tell me, what am I fighting for?
Only when we look inside ourselves can we truly begin to understand.
What is this sorcery?
How far are you prepared to go to uncover the truth?